Hey, what's up, guys? This is gonna be a little update. So last weekend we ran the LOCI-5B, getting some more fuel through her. I don't know, maybe she has like a tank and a half, a couple tanks, something like that. She's really starting to wake up. Still running pretty rich on there. Did get more fuel through the 5T with the 50 GT. She's really, really starting to wake up. I always felt like the 50, I mean, it's a heavy vehicle, so I'm not knocking anything, but I felt like she needed more in her. She's definitely running better. What else was I gonna say? She probably only has about two tanks in her, to be honest. And not consecutive, you know what I mean? So I'm gonna try to get out this weekend. I think it's gonna be the MCD maiden voyage, shakedown, see if anything's gonna come loose on her. I did put holes in the windshield to get more airflow in there. But she's ready to go. So hopefully get some good footage of that. I'm gonna get my I got a GoPro chest mount and a head mount, so I'll see what works better, just to get some better running videos. Because you really can't see how fast these things are with like a stationary camera, you know what I mean? But either way, I'm not going to be beating on this. It's just going to be a shakedown, so we'll see how that goes. So I get a lot of questions about how to make Bajas handle better. I am not the suspension guru by any means, but to get them to handle better, I mean, first of all, they're never going to handle as good as a all-wheel drive vehicle. I mean, a Baja is never going to run as good as a LOCI-5T, LOCI-5B, which in my opinion, the best handling car I have is my Vecta 5. But I can give you a little pointers, like what I noticed, what works better with certain setups, take the slop out of the steering. And I think I kind of touched base on this before. First thing I personally would do with the Baja. Okay, let me start back. I'm not a fan of symmetrical steering. Not a fan of it at all. I would say spend the money. Get the Turtle servo saver setup. That takes a lot of the slack. These are a little different. These are grass drag cars pretty much. You know what I mean? So what I would say, like with the Baja, whatever shock, I'm not gonna talk about fluid and all that stuff, but like whatever shocks you have, the main thing you want to do with the Baja, I feel like they handle better the lower they are. Or at least where the axles, when it's sitting on the ground, are straight across. You do that. You change the Turtle, get the slop out of there. You don't have to go crazy servos. I think these are high-tech ones. They're like 80-something bucks. They're fine for me for a Baja. But the lower you get the Baja, you want to make sure they're not bouncy. I feel like that handles the best with the Baja. And like I said, this is hard to compare these, because I mean these are set up for grass, just straight line ripping. But that, and I do like, let me see if I can get these out, tires play a good role. I do like these are the Uber Vipers. These are really good tires. These are Baja 5B, so these are not as tall, but they're wide. I do feel like these work really good. You guys got to remember, the more knobbier the tire, you're going to have more chances of rolling. It's going to dig, like something like this, which is obviously what you could see I have. So, they're not going to handle as good as a all-wheel drive, four-wheel drive vehicle, all-wheel drive, however you want to say it. But the right shock oil, get them, you just don't want them bouncy. and you know your ride height. You know, get the front arms and the rear arms as level as possible. I feel like that helps a lot. You know, and your diff load. See, the problem with all these, I'm running either lockers or a million weight diff load, even on my small bore Baja. You know, it's got a million weight diff oil. So, you know, the thicker the diff oil, it's going to make it more like a locker. So, which isn't going to help you on turns. So, you know, hopefully that helps. I know it's a couple, I got comments about that, how to, you know, to get them to handle better. You know, not always wider is better. I mean, this one and this one obviously are, have the FLM wide kits on them. This just has RPM arms. You know, they're not too much wider. I mean, they're, I don't know, maybe like an inch on each side, maybe. I don't know, maybe not even that much. Maybe half an inch on each side, I think the difference is roughly. But is that needed, you know, to make it handle better on a Baja? I can't say, personally. You know, for me, Bajas are just like, straight up like, you know, 60s, 70s, like muscle car, drag cars, just full throttle, let them rip down the field. You know what I mean? So, you know, take that however you want to take it. I mean, you know, there's people that know way more about the suspension on Bajas. I mean, back in the day, they used to race Bajas, you know, before Losi 5Ts even came out. So, you know, there's a lot of people probably can, you know, you talk to some of the older people about that stuff, but like for instance, like the Losi 5B, that's the one vehicle I would always have where it would you know, tilt and then roll over. You know, talking to Todd RC Ohio, you know what I mean? you know, like one thing like I just really, really started doing with this thing is when you're going around turn, you gotta like Todd says, you got to full commit it. You got to give it some gas. Because if you slow it down and those tires catch, it's going to roll. And I did that in the last video. I know you guys couldn't, you know, see all of it. I mean, I ran them. That was just a small little video of me running it. But, you know, I ran it a lot that Sunday. And she handled awesome. I really liked it. I always thought that thing rolled so easy. You know, people put the 5T arms on there. And I was actually kind of thinking about that to do that, but I don't think I'm going to do it. She handled really well. So anyway, so I'm going to try to get out this Saturday. Wife's got some, friend coming over with her kids. So it's a good chance for me to get out. The weather's supposed to be pretty good. So like I said, I think I'm going to take the, 80 hybrid out. I only ran this once and it wasn't very long. Had a couple bolts loosen up on me, you know. So I pretty much just shut her down. So I'm planning on, if it works out right, I want to take this out. One of my favorites, my Baja 46. And then I think the MCD. And if I'm out there for a long time, maybe at the end of the video, you'll see this thing, you know, get on it. You know, usually I'll bring a couple of vehicles with me. I'll run them in like 10-minute intervals of each one, kind of let one cool down. It's just kind of what I do. Other than that, I'm trying to think what else here. Yeah, I don't know. I'm just happy to get out and run. I still need to take this out. She's pretty much ready to go. But again, that'll be a, you know, shakedown pass. So we'll see how she does. I'm still waiting for my parts from ALX for my 65 Baja setup. But, you know, the 65, I was planning on putting in my 5T. But like I said, after last Sunday, this thing is really, really starting to wake up. It has so much like torque steer, like it's really hard to keep it going straight off the line. So yeah, I think that's about it. I'm trying to think what else. Yeah, I don't know. I'll do, well, like I said, I'm going to get some of those GoPro mounts, get some better actual running video instead of just the tripod mount. But just, I mean, here, I don't know. We had, it was almost like a month of no rain. And then it was freaking in the 90s. And now it's finally, you know, like 80, like next weekend, it's supposed to be like 81, which is good running weather. I ran last weekend, I think it was 85, but it was a really nice breeze. So the cars ran really good. I don't know. Like I said, I'm excited to just get out and run, you know. And again, you know, I run a good amount. I just don't always video. So like I said, I was thinking with that, the GoPro mount, like the chest mount, and I think I got a head mount. You know, try to get some good, better running videos anyways. But this is the one I'm really super excited about getting out. I think that's about it. You know, if you guys have any questions, you know, hit me up. But hopefully, you know, that helped, you know, about the Baja setup. You know, and I think they also asked, can you turn a Baja into all four-wheel drive? I've never seen that, a kit like that. I know Red Cat makes one that's kind of like a Baja, but that's four-wheel drive. But I don't know. You got to remember, like, you buy a Baja for what a Baja is. It's a rear-wheel drive car. You know, whether you have, you know, let's say, like, a real car that's rear-wheel drive, you know what I mean? It's going to get squirrely if it's got some power, you know? You know, it's not going to handle as good as, all-wheel drive Mercedes AMG, you know what I mean? You know, hopefully that kind of makes sense. But I think they handle good enough for, you know, what they are. I mean, you know, you're not going to cut corners super hard with them, you know, but if you get the less knobbier tires you have, the better, if you want to actually to turn really well, and a little lighter on the, you know, lighter on the diff fluid. And I found out, like I said, you don't want them bouncy, you want them more spongy, and put the ride height so all the arms are you know, basically as flat as you can. That's what I feel how they run better. Because, you know, the weight transfer, it's gonna push the front end up anyway. So you want to lower, you know, not scraping on the ground, but you want to lower as possible. I feel like that makes them handle better. So hopefully that helps. You know, if you want me to hit some other points, I could do my best. But like I said, I am not the best at, you know, suspension stuff. You know what I mean? I mean, I understand it, but it's probably like, you know, the least area. I don't try a thousand different weights of shock fluid. You know what I mean? If they run good, and then I leave them. I mean, if they're real bouncy, obviously, then you got to change them. But you'll know as soon as you put them on the car and, you know, give it a couple, you know, preload ups and downs, you know, on it or whatever. So hopefully that helps. Like, I can't even remember what shock fluid's in these. I want to say my Bajas are 60 weight. I want to say they're 60 weight. 60 or 50 weight. So, hopefully that helps. And like I said, this is just a little update. Just getting excited to get out to run again, like I said. Let me know if you have any questions. Hopefully that helps. And hopefully this weekend we'll get some good running videos with the GoPro mounts. And that's about it, guys. All right, have a good one.